I would say that I've been very lucky to not have to block anyone during this past week, these past couple weeks. Everyone that follows me seems to be very with the shits. However, when I saw a few people that I used to associate with or even look up to post things that were so uneducated and ignorant, I honestly feel like I need to speak up. Especially in the vegan days, I was so vocal about those issues and I was so supportive of these people for speaking up about those issues that I just feel like I need to speak up about this as well. So everybody's 2015, 2016 favorite posted something on her Instagram story that I would say it had me shocked, but honestly did it. She said on Instagram, "I agree that black lives only seem to matter when there is a white perpetrator. Think about it, statistics back it up. America is not racist. Don't fall for this propaganda." This had me speechless. I really wanted to break down this statement and look at it piece by piece. So the first sentence, "black lives only seem to matter when there's a white perpetrator." The majority of people in the United States are white. That's why we refer to people of other races as minorities, because they are the minority. There's less of them. So while this isn't to say that racism does not occur within other races other than whites, white people have the most privilege. And this really stems back to the Atlantic slave trade and how white Europeans were purchasing and selling slaves from Africa. When you have white Europeans taking over this land, killing so many Native Americans, and then bringing in African slaves, not giving them rights, not giving them access to land, education. That's how the United States was built. In the colonial era, whites were given legally or socially sanctioned privileges and rights, while the same rights were denied to other races and minorities. And these rights included education, immigration, voting rights, citizenship, land acquisition, and criminal procedure. And as we can see, this is still relevant today, especially in employment rates, housing, education, lending, and government. If you're white, you have privilege. It, again, is proven in statistics, it's proven in history. You have easier access to the things that we need to live in this society and to survive. So to deny that just proves that it does exist, because you're literally saying all of these other people's realities aren't valid or aren't real. So that just proves how out of touch of reality you are, because you're living in your little privileged bubble and you're not even paying attention to what other people are going through. And that's why they say that being silent is as harmful as being aggressively against it, because you're just sidestepping it, letting it happen. "Well, it doesn't affect me, so I'm not gonna speak out. I'm not gonna learn. I'm not gonna listen." So again, that's not to say that racism doesn't occur within other races towards black people, but there's white privilege. You know, white people are the majority. We have the most access to everything. So when she says statistics back it up, I would like to know which statistics she's referring to. Like I said, there are more white people in the United States than black people, but black people are incarcerated at 5 times the rate of white people. For example, black and white people use drugs at similar rates, but black people face charges 6 times more than white people for the same drug crimes. White families hold 90% of the national wealth. Black drivers are 30% more likely to be pulled over. One of the main ones that I think of is just birth rates, and especially birth rates comparing white mothers to black mothers. And I actually saw a TikTok that said that a lot of doctors and a lot of people thought that black people couldn't feel pain.
Do black people feel pain the same way as white people? A 2016 study showed that 50% of medical students and residents who were studied thought that black people couldn't feel pain the same way because they had thicker skin or their nerves didn't work the same way. Where is this from? It's a holdover from the days of slavery, when white people had to feel better about using slaves. Black people used to be operated on without anesthesia and were used in studies without their consent, so this was a convenient lie. To this day, black people are less likely to get the same treatment in terms of pain medication. They're more likely to wait longer in the emergency room. They're less likely to be taken seriously. It's a holdover from the days of slavery. And in my field, this plays a huge role in the black maternal and morbidity crisis. The call to action: doctors, nurses, anybody in the medical field, check your implicit bias. If you see somebody spreading these lies, stop them, but still stop yourself every time you're caring for somebody who has a different skin color than you, and check your bias. If you are a woman of color, speak up. If this is happening to you, ask to speak to a different nurse, a different doctor, report them, speak up.
So that's just another example of racism starting back in the day and still having an effect on people today. Black people are 13% of the general population and 40% of the prison population. I feel like people look at those stats and think, well, they're just getting arrested more because they do more crime. But an area is more poor than another, that area is going to be more policed. So more crimes are going to be caught, even though crimes are happening at around the same rate. So more people from that area that is being more policed are going to have higher rates of crime just because more of them are caught, which is why we say to defund the police, because in doing so, we could invest money back into communities and give people access to education, healthcare. A lot of crime is predictable and a lot of crime is due to there not being another option. So then the last sentence, America is not racist, don't fall for this propaganda. I don't understand how it's propaganda when it's literal statistics and literal history that backs it up. Also, as a white person to say America is not racist, that just shows how privileged you are because you're not experiencing it. Yeah, of course it doesn't seem racist to you because you have the privilege. What statistics are you looking at that says America isn't racist? It's times like this where people really show their ass and they really just show how ignorant, small-minded, racist, and stupid they are. Why would you try to defend not being racist or America is not being racist so hard when instead you could be using your privilege to listen to people who are being oppressed? Why would you want to be stuck in these old ways? And especially for this person, someone who is vegan, it just shows that you care more about animals than people who aren't white. And that is just classic. I just really had to get that off my chest. So thank you guys so much for listening. If you have any links to any educational resources or petitions or fundraisers, etc., please don't hesitate to leave them down below or share them to me on Instagram so I can post them on my story. It's times like this that really highlight how much we need to work together. And I just think it's so amazing that all of the protests and all of the petitions and donations have already made a difference. The power is really in the people. And we shouldn't let dumbasses like this make us feel like we're not gonna speak out or we don't have to speak out. Also, I would just have to say, be careful who you look up to and be careful who you idolize, because you never really know someone's true intentions or mindset or who they really are at their core, what their true morals are, until they expose themselves, like so many people have done in these past couple of weeks. Thank you guys so much for watching. All the resources that I'm aware of will be linked down below. I'll do what we can to help, and I will talk to you guys in my next video.